Welcome back. We are now going to learn a little bit more about the ICTP international network that this morning Adish Dabolkar was referring to. Please welcome with me the ICTP Head of Programmes, Ralf Kaiser.
Okay, good afternoon. So you've just seen the little video. And at the moment, Imrana, who's one of the associates that we have at the moment at ICTP, is actually in the room. She's big there. If you don't mind, give her a round of applause. Thank you so much. So we are coming to the last panel of the day. This is going to be a panel about partnerships. ICTP can accomplish its mission only through partnerships. Partnerships with organizations at many different levels and all around the world. We're working with member states, funding agencies, research laboratories and institutes, universities, foundations, academies, learned societies, other UN agencies and international organizations, national organizations, and private individuals. Now, it's a long list, but I probably still forgot a couple. We're really working with everybody. On this panel on partnerships today, we have with us representatives of many of these different kinds of partners, and I'd like to welcome my panelists and ask them to please come and sit with me. So we do not have slides for this one because we need to be a little faster. It's the last panel of the day, so it's also the shortest one, because we know that we're getting on in time, and after this and after one more thing, then we're at the drinks reception. So please bear with us. So let me introduce our panelists. We have Her Excellency Raïssa Malu Dinanga. She's the Minister of State of National Education and New Citizenship of the Democratic Republic of the Congo. She also has a particular connection to UNESCO, a senior referent for UNESCO's International Bureau of Education. Next to her is Professor Ricardo Galvão from Brazil. He's the president of the National Council for Scientific and Technological Development of Brazil, and I understand that he's just signed an agreement with ICTP today. Thank you, Professor Galvão. Then we have Professor Rolf Heuer, who's well known to a lot of people here at ICTP. He's here wearing at least three hats. That one doesn't really see that, but there are really at least minimum three hats. So he's a former director general of CERN, and as you've seen in a previous presentation, we are working with CERN. He's also the president of the Sesame Council, the Sesame Accelerator in the Middle East. And he's here also, in particular today, as member of the board of the Wilhelm and Elsa Heraeus Foundation, who is a funding agency that is supporting us. And next week, we will here at ICTP have a joint activity together, supported by Heraeus and with Heraeus. Last but not least, Professor Caterina Petrillo, the president of the Area Science Park here in Trieste. She's essentially representing the... So she's also representing the Trieste science system. And you've heard before that Trieste is special in the sense that it has the highest density of scientists, like per capita density of scientists in Europe. And ICTP is working embedded in the science system here in Trieste. Thank you very much for being here. Okay, let's move down. So let's start with a couple of questions, if you don't mind. Your Excellency, could I ask you to tell us about the role the partnership with ICTP plays in transforming the education and science system in the Democratic Republic of Congo, and how does this partnership contribute to the vision of science by and for Africa?
Thank you, Ralf. First, I would like to thank Atish and the entire ICTP team for inviting me. You know, my personal story is closely linked to the ICTP, as my father, Professor Felix Malua Kalinga, was a friend of late Professor Abdus Salam, and they worked together in establishing the TWAS, the World Academic Academy of Science. So thank you for so much, because their collaboration inspired my passion for science and my determination to support the development of scientific capacity in the Democratic Republic of Congo and across Africa. The ICTP has already been instrumental for the DRC. Over 200 Congolese scientists have benefited from its program, strengthening our national capacity and contributing to African scientific progress. Today, as a Minister of National Education, I am committed to taking this relation further. We need partnership that can help transform our educational system and make science accessible to all citizens, to all our citizens, particularly women and marginalized communities. As part of our effort to promote science, we have organized in the DRC 11 consecutive editions of the Science and Technology Week. It's an outreach initiative that has highlighted the immense potential of young Congolese in the field of science, technology, engineering, and math. It serves as a vital platform for encouraging scientific curiosity among young people, among women, among girls, and aspiring them to pursue career in STEM field. Through the collaboration with ICTP, we hope to further expand this opportunity for our youth. Second, we have in our ministry, a five-year plan for education, 2024-2029, who is also aligned with this vision. We aim to enhance access to quality education, promote equity and inclusion, integrate digital technologies, and strengthen teacher training. The plan also places great emphasis on developing new form of citizenship, instilling values of responsibility and community engagement in our young people. These priorities reflect our ambition to create an education system that not only imparts knowledge, but also builds character and prepares our children for a globalized and digital future. So our vision is to use science as a tool to transformation by Africa and for Africa. Through partnership with ICTP, we can develop new fellowship program targeting women, especially women, and support innovative research in areas such as renewable energy and resource management, which are very important for us. We also want to improve the quality of science education in our school, by integrating digital technologies and providing training for our teachers. And we believe that ICT support could be crucial for building this foundation. So ladies and gentlemen, the DRC, Democratic Republic of Congo, is at the beginning of a scientific journey that is both challenging and exciting. We aspire to reinforce our collaboration with ICTP to develop local expertise, build research programs which are relevant to our national priorities, and inspire the generation, a new generation of scientists who will lead Africa toward a more prosperous future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So let's move a little bit around the world. We're moving from Africa to Latin America. Professor Galvão, can you tell us a little bit about the connection between Brazil and ICTP? Perhaps going back to the scientists that already worked with Abdus Salam to today's activities of SAFER in Sao Paulo.
Well, first, thank you, Atish, for the invitation. And it's very nice to be here. I was touched this morning before I answered the question, when someone said that's one of the only places that Iran scientists can come now to discuss. I remember when ICTP was created, it was very important in my area of research. I'm a fusion scientist, as said. At the time, in 1964, fusion research was much more advanced in Soviet Union than in Western countries. And it was precise in 1964 that was a meeting here, scientists from Soviet Union of the level Kadontsev, Sagdiev, and Shafranov and Menners, others, with American scientists also, Marshall Rosenbluth Harold Forth, and that was very important. When I started doing my PhD, the only good book on fusion was precisely the proceedings of that meeting. So it shows how important ICTP has been to develop not only science in developing countries, but also this interplay exchange between different cultures. Atish, you made a short history of ICTP, but I have to remember in the beginning of the 60s, that was a hard decision. It was very politically discussed, and I found out a citation from Alex de Greif on the story of ICTP. The crucial year, they said, was 1963. And the Atomic Energy Agency decided then to convene a meeting of the three advisors to study the offers of the facilities at the time. And they say that he has no details of the criteria used to select the members. Nevertheless, the three wise men were Robert Marshak, Leon von Hoff, and Jaime Tiomono, a Brazilian that was a very good friend of Salan. So the involvement of Brazil is ICTP, come from that time, and was very successful. In the case of Brazil, ICTP was very important. From 1970 to now, were over 5,000 visitors. And many that were got prizes, and Abdul Salam Prize, for instance, was given for a very famous Brazilian physicist that unfortunately passed away already, Sergio Mascarenhas, who started here medical physics. And the importance of that, the Brazilian that came here, when went back to Brazil, they were recognized for their involvement in science and interchange with other scientists. And that was essential to get, as we're discussing, to get the politicians accept a bit of what science has to say about the strategies for development of Brazil. And that has been always so. We had also, in the case of climate change that we discussed, we had many meetings in ICTP, and Brazilian scientists like Carlos Nobre, men that came here, because they had this somewhat, they came to the limelight through ICTP, they were more accepted in Brazil by the politicians. And I also have to thank very much ICTP, not only for Brazil, but also for Latin America. Through collaboration with ICTP, ICTP Salan accepted a proposal of three very well-known Latin America scientists, Argentina, Juan Miaco, the Brazilian, sorry, not Juan, Juan Jambiage, but was advisor of Miaco, and also Marx Mochinski from Mexico, and José Leite Lopes from Brazil. So through the action of ICTP, we were able to create in Rio the Latin America Center for Physics. That's operated, it came before ICTP actually, and that has been very important for developing physics in Latin America and Brazil. So I thank you very much for what ICTP has done for our countries.
Thank you very much, Professor Galvão. Professor Heuer, I've already mentioned the different hats that you're wearing all the time. I'd like to ask you about the Heraeus Foundation, because we're having this activity that we're doing together next week. So maybe you can tell us a little bit about what you find interesting about your foundation working with ICTP.
Yeah, thank you very much, and thank you for the invitation. First of all, I wear the hats one after the other, not all at the same time. Wilhelm and Else Heraeus Foundation is a relatively small foundation, and that should now really give you the first negative of this day, Atish. We cannot support any new infrastructure at ICTP. But what we can support are the other things, and that's the positive part, which you mentioned this morning already. People, especially young people, and collaboration. Collaboration not only within your own field or own area, but beyond. I think that is the very important thing. Let me first say a few words to the it's really on here, to the Wilhelm and Else Heraeus Foundation. It is mainly oriented towards physics, and it works very closely together with the German Physical Society. And we are supporting workshops, meetings, trainings, not only for people who are already at the university, but also for young people in schools. And this is, I must say, a very refreshing thing to see these young people. Recently, I had the fantastic experience, a young lady around 14 years old, that's the youngest what we did, in perfect English, presenting her results of a question which they had to work on. When I was 14, I would never have been able to do that. And you see, it's so refreshing to support such people. And the foundation would like to support more also outside Germany, outside the north of Europe or middle of Europe. And who could be a better partner than ICTP with all the connections to the global south? And this is why we want to do that here. And it's not our first workshop together with you next week. There was one in April, if I'm not mistaken, on a completely different topic, both related to physics. But the main thing is to bring these people together from many different regions, different countries, different cultures. That's the important thing. And this is why I have also this third hat on Sesame, but I think you asked only about Heraeus, so I answer only on Heraeus.
Thank you very much, Professor Heuer. So as I briefly mentioned before, Trieste has this enormous density of researchers, and that's of course also related to the Trieste science system and the institutes all here in Trieste. Perhaps, Professor Petrillo, you can tell us a little bit about the Trieste science system and what makes it special.
Yes, thank you. Thanks for the invitation, Atish. And I'm at home here. And what I'll try to do now is just to give you some local flavor. And I would like to underline the role that ICTP played to shape the present Trieste science system and the present system of research and innovation of all the Friuli Venezia Giulia, the region where we are. This is important. This is we must recognize. A lot of things have been said. You know the ICTP very well, but an important thing to say is that ICTP was founded in 1964 for several reasons that have been discussed today. But this was just the first step. This was a driver. I mean, ICTP was a tool to push for the development of further scientific institutions in this area. The list is very long, and I need to go through looking at my notes. And what you should consider is that today, nowadays, Friuli Venezia Giulia is considered, according to the European Innovation Scoreboard, one of the strong innovators. A region that is a strong innovator in Europe. And this is because of the system that was created starting from that time. More precisely, after the ICTP and after the successful work that was done by ICTP, in 1978, three more institutions, scientific institutions, were created. One was Area Science Park, I'm the president of this, And this is devoted to technology transfer, knowledge sharing, I mean, a specific mission, but also the CISA, the School International, the Scuola Internazionale di Studi, Scuola Internazionale Superiore di Studi Avanzati, so International Advanced Scientific School. And I think that you know this, and the collaborations between ICTP and CISA here are very strong. And the other one was the University of Udine. The University of Trieste was already here. This year we celebrated 100 years of this university. Maybe 100 years cannot seem a long period to other academics. I'm looking at the Padua colleagues or others. But you should consider that 100 years ago there was no Italy here. There was Austria. I mean, so there is a reason for all these things. In 1983 there was TWAS, the World Academy of Science, that in 1991 became a UNESCO program. In 1986, and that's very important, it was founded ICGB, the International Center of Genetic Engineering and Biotechnology, that is hosted in Area. And this is an important piece of this story, because this is a center that has a high profile in research, and it has, as the ICTP, a very wide and developed training program with working with under development countries. In 1994, it became an international organization, and now it's funded by 66 countries. So another important piece of our history. In 1987, the OWSD, the Organization for Women Development, was founded, and last but not least, in 1993, Elettra, the National Synchrotron Light, and in 2010, Fermi, the free electron lasers. You can find all these things here, very close one to each other. In 2014, CERIC, the research infrastructure oriented towards the Balkans and Eastern Europe facilities. And then we arrive in 2016. This was the year of foundation of YAP, the Inter-Academy Panel, that is a UNESCO program, and the signature of the CIS, what I mentioned before, and that it was mentioned this morning by Atish. It means Sistema della Scienza e dell'Innovazione del Friuli Venezia Giulia, but it was founded and signed through a memorandum of understanding between the region, the local authorities, and the our foreign affairs minister and the minister of research and the university. So it was a program committed to put together all these institutions, and many more were added, because today there are 18 institutions, science and technology parks, that are grouped together and form a real ecosystem of institutions. This is something that is very special and very unique to Trieste. I think you cannot find this so easily in other areas of Europe or the globe. So why ICTP was so relevant for that? Because it was the starting point, because they started with a very strong program devoted to training, but at the same time, scientific excellence, high scientific and profile. And this is something that is absolutely necessary to attract people and to attract scientists, to attract the best researchers. I want just to finish this by saying what can be done in the future by the ICTP. This is very personal point of view. We heard this morning about the Consortium for Scientific Computing, and I think that it has a clear mission that has been described, but maybe having such a well-developed network of trained people all over the world. Through this consortium, we or you could also consider the possibility of dealing with data that are validated by people that are trained. So in this way, we can also think or discuss about the use of validated data, which means no fake data, research, security and safety aspects that nowadays are important. So this is maybe is a collateral impact that ICTP could have through this already established consortium and using and making use of so well-trained young people all over the world. So, thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Petrillo. Thank all of our panelists. I think we've gotten a really interesting cross-section of all the different kinds of partnerships that ICTP has. I'd like to thank you once more. Thank you.